Joining us now to talk about all this, Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning. Thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
So let's start with this CDC reporting 28 more blood clot cases from that Johnson & Johnson vaccine, but you still say the risk of dying of COVID still much greater than getting these blood clots.
Much greater, Robin, incredibly greater. COVID really causes a lot of problems, and people don't realize these kind of side effects occur with the disease as well. Now, it's not occurring with the Pfizer and Moderna vaccine. It's only with the Johnson & Johnson and AstraZeneca vaccine. Here in the United States, we only have the Johnson & Johnson one. We don't have the AstraZeneca one. And the number is up, like you said, 28 people have this very, very serious side effect that has killed 3 people and 4 people still in the hospital. So it's still 1 in 300,000 people who've taken it. However, there's very well-defined risk groups. Still, women under 50 years of age are at risk for this, very high risk. Obese people, very high risk for this. Other side effects include the usual ones for bad outcomes with COVID, like high blood pressure and diabetes. But also on this report, 3 of the women were on birth control pills. Why would anybody want to be taking this vaccine especially a woman under 50 years of age? Now, there's also 6 men in this. And so that's also included. And they are under 60 years of age, but there's very few of them.
Northwestern University requiring vaccines. And I think people are wondering, how widespread will this go where you must have a vaccine to do certain things?
It's going to go everywhere, I think. I mean, it's working so well with the limited amount of vaccine really that we've had out there. Look at the numbers. I mean, that death rate really going down, the highest risk people getting vaccinated. This is working. You're gonna see the schools are gonna start because they can mandate it. That's what they did with hepatitis B. That's what they do with measles. And those diseases just go away. And now we're going to have the 12 to 15 year olds. So the whole middle school and high schools, if they do the same thing, they're going back to normal very soon.
And what about these mixing vaccines, the side effects from that? We've heard mixed messages about that.
Yeah, so the Brits did it because they were having this huge crisis a couple months ago, you may remember. And so they just couldn't get the vaccines out there. They couldn't get the right vaccine to the right place. They just said, just give any vaccine. So fortunately, the scientific people there said, well, if we're gonna do this, let's study it. So they studied it. They actually set up an 830 person trial where they mixed and matched the vaccines. So far, so good. There are more minor side effects, more of the headache and fever, the one day type side effects. No major side effects were reported in this that they're reporting anyway now. And the immunological effect, we don't know yet. They're analyzing that right now. But anyway, that it's a very minor problem. And so that's not going to stop this mix and matching thing. But let's see how good the immunology is.
All right. Viewer questions. I own and am the only stylist in a small hair salon. I am fully vaccinated. Is it safe to let my fully vaccinated clients come in without wearing masks? We are the only people in the salon at one time.
So this is a really loaded question. It's a very good question. And people are saying, hey, everyone's vaccinated. Why am I still wearing a mask? The CDC has come under intense criticism this week in particular for their very conservative views on wearing masks. The formal recommendation is that you still wear a mask. On a practical level, vaccinated people are not transmitting this disease in any significant way. Yes, a rare case, but even if you get the disease and you're vaccinated, you get a very mild disease, super mild. So, on a practical level, you have to make your own decision. Officially, you're supposed to still wear the mask.
All right, next question. I have a family member who had COVID and does not want to get vaccinated yet because they believe they need to wait 90 days after they recovered. This seems like a long time to hold off.
Well, the reason for this is that very few recurrent second COVID cases occur in the 3 months after you get sick. And so you're protected from the original infection. But there's no real hard and fast rule about when you get the vaccine. Matter of fact, the recommendation formally is, as soon as your symptoms are completely resolved, you can take the vaccine. You don't have to wait 90 days.
All right, next question. My father has had the worst migraine since he was 17 years old, and he's in his 80s. Since he's had the vaccine, he has had no migraines. Have you heard of this before?
I have never heard of this, and I think it's really fascinating, and it shows that we just don't know enough about this disease. Remember at the beginning of this disease, the whole thing about loss of smell, it wasn't hardly reported. It was single-digit reporting. And then when we started, when it did get reported, people started asking. It turns out it's over 50% of people have some problem with the smell and the taste. So it's the same thing here. These kind of outcomes are, not being reported. So, this would be, it's hard to report. I don't have a side effect, but I don't know exactly how you do that. But, this could be like a little medical report in some journal, like something. I did ask Igor Koralnik at Northwestern, who's got this big neurology COVID clinic going with thousands of people. I sent a message to him this morning, so maybe I'll get some information back tomorrow if he's ever heard of it. If anybody in Chicago has heard of it, it's him. So we'll see, but I think it's really fascinating.
All right, thanks, Dr. Murphy. If you have a question for the doctor, post it on our Morning News Facebook page. We'll talk to him again tomorrow. Have a good day.
Hey, great.
Thanks, doctor.